Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss about topiramate. What is this drug topiramate? This drug belongs to the category of antiepileptic drugs, commonly known as AEDs. So topiramate is an antiepileptic or anticonvulsant agent, and this drug acts by targeting different types of ion channels. One of the ion channels is the voltage gated sodium channel, through which sodium can enter, and second one is the voltage gated calcium channels, through which calcium can enter. These two ion channels are responsible for excitation of the CNS. Now when the sodium and calcium are entering into the cells, they produce excitation, and by this excitation within the CNS, the neuronal activity is increased, resulting in the asynchronous neuronal discharge, leading to epilepsy in the patients. So by repeated stimulation of these excitatory ion channels result in the epilepsy, but this excitatory response can be controlled by a few of the other ion channels such as chloride channels. These chloride channels are operated through GABA gated mechanism. So when these chloride channels are activated, they can reduce the excitatory response. Now topiramate is one of the anti-epileptic agent which can modulate these ion channel activity. Thereby it can reduce the excitatory response within the CNS. So today in this video, we are going to discuss about this topiramate, how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, clinical uses, we will discuss in this video. Topiramate can be used as monotherapy as well as adjunctive therapy. It can be combined with other drugs like valproic acid in the treatment of epilepsy. Similarly, it can be used as a prophylactic in the treatment of migraine, particularly used only in the adults. So this drug topiramate can be used in the treatment of generalized tonic-clonic seizures, partial onset seizures, even Lennox-Gastaut syndrome, which is produced by excessive stimulation of NMDA receptors. In all these conditions, topiramate can be used as a monotherapy, otherwise it can be combined with other anti-epileptic agents. And this drug can be used both in the adults as well as pediatric patients. But when it is used in the children, the age should be greater than 2 years. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the basic ring system present in this topiramate. So this is a 6-member ring system with several hydroxyl groups. So this is nothing but fructopyranose ring system. And here it is having the beta configuration. So we can write this as beta D fructopyranose, which is attached with the sulfonamide. So this is a central ring present in this structure. Now at the second and third position, as well as fourth and fifth position, this ring is closed by isopropyl group. So here isopropyl group is attached at second and third, as well as fourth and fifth positions. Since it is attached by same carbon, it is called as isopropylidine. So we can write this as 2,3,4,5-O-isopropylidine. Because it is attached by oxygen, we can write this as O-isopropylidine. So that is the complete name of topiramate. Now let us see how this drug acts. Within the CNS, the presynaptic neurons are equipped with excitatory mediators such as glutamate, and the release of glutamate is controlled by voltage-gated calcium channels which produce exocytosis. Similarly, the voltage-gated sodium channels can activate the presynaptic neurons such that the neurotransmitters can be released. Similarly, at the postsynaptic neurons, receptors for glutamate are present. For instance, AMP receptors are fast-acting inotropic receptors which are coupled with sodium channels. Now, the sodium can excite the presynaptic neurons through the voltage-gated sodium channels. Then the calcium can enter through the voltage-gated calcium channels which produce the exocytosis, and the released glutamate can act on AMPA receptors. When these receptors are activated, they can allow the sodium through the ion channels, so sodium enters into the postsynaptic neuron which produce the excitation of the neuron. In this way, postsynaptic neurons are excited by release of the neurotransmitters such as glutamate. But this excitatory response is controlled by another type of ion channels. They are the GABA-gated chloride channels. Now, when the GABA binds to these GABA-gated chloride channels, the chloride ions can enter into the cell, such that they can produce inhibition, thereby they can control excitatory response. In this way, ion channels can produce either excitation or inhibition. Now, topiramate is one of the drug which can act on the different types of ion channels. It can block the voltage-gated sodium channels such that excitation of presynaptic neurons can be reduced. Similarly, it can block the voltage-gated calcium channels so that the neurotransmitter release can be prevented. And even it can block AMPA-associated sodium channels, which are also called as ligand-gated sodium channels. Thereby, they can inhibit EPSP, excitatory postsynaptic potential. In this way, topiramate can block all these type of ion channels, thereby it can prevent the excitation. Similarly, this drug can bind to GABA-A receptors at the non-benzodiazepine site, but instead of inhibition, it can activate these receptors, resulting in the opening of chloride channels. And when this chloride enters into the cell, it produces inhibitory response. In this way, topiramate can control CNS excitation. That's why it is used as antiepileptic agent as well as migraine prophylactic. Now let us see the precautions of topiramate. One of the important precautions of this drug is that this drug can increase the risk of angle closure glaucoma. So if a patient already having any glaucoma, this can be further increased by topiramate, and this drug can reduce the visual acuity in the patients, and it can also precipitate acute myopia, short-sightedness, and even it can produce the ocular hyperemia. Redness of the eye can be observed with this drug, and increased ocular pain and increased intraocular pressure can also be observed, and it can also produce blurred vision. So care should be taken to monitor any change in the visual acuity in the patients, and those patients who are having the risk of developing glaucoma, they should avoid this topiramate. And this angle closure glaucoma can be developed within 1 month of the treatment. Another important precaution is on the bicarbonate levels. At the proximal convoluted tubule, sodium as well as bicarbonate are reabsorbed from the apical membrane. Sodium can enter into the tubular membrane for the exchange of proton. Now this proton and bicarbonate can be combined to produce carbonic acid. This carbonic acid is split into water and carbon dioxide by the carbonic anhydrase enzyme. The same process is repeated within the tubular membrane such that carbonic acid is reconverted into proton and bicarbonate. Now the sodium and bicarbonate which are present in the tubular membrane, they can be reabsorbed into the systemic circulation. In this way, sodium bicarbonate is reabsorbed at the proximal convoluted tubule. But topiramate can block the carbonic anhydrase enzyme activity such that the bicarbonate is not reabsorbed properly, which results in the decreased bicarbonate levels, resulting in metabolic acidosis. When the bicarbonate levels are reduced, proton levels are increased, resulting in metabolic acidosis. Few of the other drugs which produce metabolic acidosis may interact with this topiramate, so care should be taken to monitor bicarbonate levels in the patients. Similarly, topiramate can reduce the cognitive as well as psychomotor performance. This drug can produce some confusion, difficulty with concentration as well as attention, decreased memory, mood changes, somnolence, sleepiness, as well as fatigue in the patients. Particularly, these are more observed with increase in the age. So, if already patient is having any cognitive disturbances, then this topiramate should be carefully used. Another important precaution is that this drug produces some fetal toxicity. So, in the pregnant woman, when this drug is prescribed, it can produce cleft lip in the newborn as well as cleft palate, a small opening at the mouth, and even it can reduce the fetal weight. So topiramate produces significant fetal toxicity, so it is less preferred in the pregnant woman. Similarly, this drug can increase the ammonia levels within the serum, resulting in the hyperammonemia, and it can also produce some renal stones. So care should be taken to monitor these conditions, and even it can produce loss of sensation, paresthesias. Another important precaution of this drug is that this drug can increase the suicidal initiation. Just we have discussed that this drug can produce psychomotor disturbances resulting in mood changes, depression, which may lead to suicidal initiation in the patients. And this drug, when it is used in the pediatric patients, it can produce the one of the condition oligohydrosis, the decreased sweating, which increase the body temperature. So any raise in the body temperature with use of this drug should be closely monitored, which may produce some confusion, nausea, and mental retardation in the patients. What are the side effects? The important side effects of this drug include somnolence, dizziness, ataxia, loss of balance, vertigo, reeling sensation, and constipation and dry mouth. It can also increase the nervousness in the patients, fatigue, insomnia, anorexia, loss of appetite, rhinitis, some weight loss, loss of memory, and flushing can be observed in the patients. How it is given? This drug is available as tablet as well as capsules. Extended-release capsules are also available. The dose of the drug depends on the type of clinical indication and the age group of the patient. For the treatment of epilepsy as a monotherapy, in the adults as well as pediatric patients with age greater than 10 years, this drug should be started at a low dose, and the dose can be increased with every week of the treatment. The initial dose is 25 mg given twice daily. That means the total dose is 50 mg per day. So all these doses are given twice daily, and initially the dose is increased by 25 mg. So on the second week it is 50 mg, third week 75 mg, fourth week 100 mg. All these are given twice daily. But from the fifth week onwards, the increment is 50 mg. So it will be 150 mg on the fifth week and 200 mg on the sixth week, given twice daily. In this way, the dose is slowly escalated from the first week to the sixth week. But in the patients with age 2 to 10 years, again the initial dose is 25 mg but given once daily. And the dose can be increased such that 50 mg per day, and the final dose is variable from 250 to 100 mg per day based on the body weight of the patient. Similarly, for epilepsy as adjunctive therapy, it is given at a dose of 25 to 50 mg per day, and the dose can be increased up to 200 to 400 mg per day. But in the pediatric patients with age 2 to 16 years, the initial dose is 25 mg, and which can be increased up to 5 to 9 mg per kg of the body weight per day. Similarly, for the migraine prophylaxis, this drug is given only for adults. Again, the dose is escalated for 4 weeks. The initial dose is 25 mg given once daily, then 50, 75 and 100, which are given as divided doses. So on the 4th week, the 50 mg twice daily is given such that 100 mg per day can be achieved. So that's about this topiramate. Topiramate is a antiepileptic agent which can block voltage-gated sodium channels, voltage-gated calcium channels, and AMPA-gated sodium channels. But at the same time, it can activate GABA-gated chloride channels which produce the inhibitory response. So that's about this topiramate. In our next video, we will come with another important antiepileptic agent. So that's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.